Gray Tappan. I'm a geographer with the U.S. Geological Survey, EROS Center. Most of that time focused on West Africa. Now, Africa really stands out because there's a lot of U.S. foreign aid going to Africa and a lot of need for the remote sensing, and so there were a lot of interest in bringing these technologies to Africa. There have been other atlases, and they very effectively showcased satellite imagery, particularly Landsat, as a way of looking at natural resources and problems with those resources, degradation or conservation problems, and particularly changes. No one had really tackled multi-date mapping and the trends that you get from that. So that's really the contribution of our work in these 17 countries and for the whole region.
I am Francis Dwomoh from Ghana. My research is basically using various kinds of remote sensing data sets to look at climate, land use, land cover, wildfires, how they are changing in space and time, and how they interact to affect forest loss. I basically look at the West African sub-region along the Atlantic coast, you know, mainly from Ghana all the way to Guinea.
There were challenges at several levels. One is the sheer magnitude, the sheer size of West Africa, the vast area of West Africa, the complexity of the landscapes, the diversity, and then there were methodology challenges of how do you map land cover through time and get it right. We decided early on in this project to go with just the good old-fashioned visual analysis, visual mapping, manual mapping of Landsat imagery, visual interpretation.
In our landscape, the changes are quite heterogeneous, and they occur at a very, very fine scale. You know, people are farming at the order of, say, acres, 1 acre, 1 hectare, and that kind of thing. So to be able to resolve that kind of detail, you need a sensor like Landsat, and it has been very valuable in this kind of investigations.
The whole mapping effort and monitoring effort with Landsat and, you know, the tools that we developed here, the idea was to do the mapping with them as partners, never to do the mapping for them, but with them. We sort of were there as facilitators, providing the imagery, some of the GIS experience, the tools, but the mapping was done, a lot of it was done by them. And then if there were problems in, you know, I mean, it's again, the challenges of correctly interpreting mapping with Landsat, so they're problems. But so some of the challenges they had, we would review their results and bring everything up to, a high level of accuracy.
With these data sets, I'm able to see those changes. But when I bring in other data sets, like climate, population growth, and other socioeconomic data, then it's able to give me a better understanding of not only why the changes are occurring as the map shows, but what is driving those kind of changes. It's gratifying to know that Gray's data captures some of this change from 1973 all the way to the 2000s. It's something that is critically important, and I think even for the local people, the local communities who see dwindling fortunes in their livelihoods because they've seen all these resources disappearing over the time, they can be able to sit down with their resource managers and be able to see where the changes are occurring, where and when. And that is valuable for them to plan ahead.
Just to get those trends and put a visual behind them is really important, and that's getting the attention at the national, you know, there are a lot of presidents and prime ministers now who've seen our work and have been talking about it and calling for more, you know, monitoring. So it does flag some of the major problems that the region is experiencing, environmental problems, problems of, you know, limited land, limited resources, and a fast-growing population. But the case studies, particularly the case studies that we did, also show lots of successes in land management that lead to, you know, viable ecosystem services, stability, improvements in some cases. There are vast areas of southern Niger, which is a very dry country, that have far more tree cover today than in 20, 30, 40 years ago. And our work directly shows that. And it was, in fact, thanks to time series images that prove that, yeah, there's, you know, way much more tree cover in southern Niger, parts of Mali, parts of Burkina, than 30, 40 years ago, despite the growing population. So it's not intuitive, but there were some huge success stories that have caught the attention of the world, really.